All right, so I've got someone watching my children downstairs. I stopped and got myself an overpriced coffee, and we're gonna do this. Welcome back, guys. Today I wanted to sit down and I wanted to talk about having more babies. What does that look like in my life? I've gotten so many questions from you guys. I have done natural family planning in the past, and I have 4 children who are 5 and under. And so not only is my life crazy, but the number one question that I get asked is, are you having more kids? Are you guys wanting more? How many are you going to have? I think my mom asked me one time, she's like, are you gonna have like 8 kids? Are you gonna be one of those people that have like 8 kids? I mean, and she was totally being honest. My mom's the oldest of 9, and so she was totally being honest and just really wanted to know how many kids John and I were going to have. I love my children. I feel like I always need to put this disclaimer if I'm putting anything on the internet that somebody might take offense to, which is probably anything that you'd put on the internet someone would take offense to. But whatever, regardless, I will say I love all my children. I would not take back having my children in the order that I had them, in the way that I had them. I am very blessed in the sense that I have had 4 natural childbirths without any kind of trauma. I've had 4 beautiful children, and I'm very blessed, and I know that, and I'm so thankful for that, and I'm eternally grateful. So I want to put that out there. All of that to say, I don't think we're gonna have any more kids of our own. I don't wanna be pregnant again, I don't feel like. You know, pregnancy, it's hard. As beautiful as it is, it's very hard. And I get very sick. With each baby that I've had, it's gotten worse. And with each baby that I've had another child to take care of that needs me and depends on me through that time. And if I'm sick, it's so hard for me to take care of those children and to be the mom that I wanna be for them. Not only do I have sickness during pregnancy, but we all know pregnancy makes our hormones go crazy. You know, we don't feel like ourselves. I don't feel like myself when I'm pregnant. And so not only when I'm pregnant am I out of my norm for 9 months, but my whole family is. Everybody rides that with me, you know? And we've done that 4 times in the last 5-6 years. Not only do we do the whole pregnancy thing, but I do the whole postpartum thing. And I have a really hard time postpartum. I've shared that with you guys. It's very difficult for me. And so I know that my husband and my family, they all make sacrifices, and everybody comes together to help me through that postpartum period. I'm not ignorant to that. I know that it is an entire family thing, and I totally get that. And as much as I believe it's worth it because I love my children, I also don't want to go through postpartum again. And I don't want to put my whole family and the children that I do have through another postpartum time if I don't have to. I really just want to focus on the children that I have and pour into them, being the best version of myself that I can be for them. I guess that's what it is. I want to be the best version of myself that I can be for my family and for my kids. And for me, that is not being pregnant and not being immediately post. I feel like because I had more time to recover after having Jude, to get back to my normal self, it was the first time that I had ever been pre-pregnancy weight since having kids, because my first 3 were so close together in age that I never got to have that. I never got to have my body back, in a sense. And that isn't just my physical body, that's emotionally, mentally, I just felt like myself again. And since I felt like myself again, I realized how long I hadn't felt like myself, you know? And because I started to have a little bit more freedom with the kids, Jude wasn't as dependent on me because he wasn't nursing anymore, and my kids could play, and we started venturing into a different season, and then I had another newborn. I realize now that I think I'm ready for that next season. I think I'm ready to go and have adventures with my kids, to go on vacations with my family, to you know, really hone in on homeschooling my children and discipling them, building relationships with with my children and with my community, with our church, maybe leading worship more often at my church, maybe, you know, going on more dates with my husband. Like, I guess I'm ready for the next season. And I feel like sometimes there's a lot of negativity or there's a stigma around being ready for the next season of motherhood and being ready to get out of the baby stuff, you know? There's this stigma. You don't ever want to say that because that everyone always tells you, like, oh, don't say that. You're going to regret it. Like, it goes by so fast. And I, hear me out. I totally get that. I look at pictures of Fiona and Ezra just from a year ago and I see how fast they've grown. And so I get that. I totally know that. But on the other hand, I have been in survival mode, per se, for the last almost 6 years. I've had two under two, I've had three under three, and now I have four, five, and under, and so my hands have been full. I've been that mom at Walmart with the screaming kids and the old guy that walks by and says, wow, you have your hands full. Like, that's been me for the last 6 years. And I own that and I love my children and I will, I do not apologize for that because that's been my life and it's been a huge, huge blessing. However, I think I'm ready to move into the next chapter, to stop being pregnant or postpartum or nursing consistently, you know what I'm saying? And I think that's okay. And I feel like I have a hard time saying that because I don't want to sound like I'm ungrateful. But on the same token, I do feel like it's okay for me to feel like I'm ready. Like, that's all right, you know? Just like it's all right for me to have four kids, five and under, even if other people might not like it, it's okay for me to say, I don't think I want to be pregnant again. And that's okay. I don't think I want to be postpartum again. And that's all right. Thank you guys so much for sitting down and kind of listening to my heart on this. It is difficult for me to talk about something so personal on the internet because I don't want anybody to take this the wrong way. Someone that struggles with infertility, someone that believes that God's going to give them as many children as he desires, like, whatever your family looks like, whatever your journey is, please don't take my journey personally because it is just my journey and we all have different lives, different capacities, different homes, different marriages. Like, we all are different. And so this is just my life. This is where we're at right now. And my husband and I are constantly changing and growing and evolving as people. I don't have it all. I don't know it all. And this is just where we're at right now. And so thank you guys so much for listening. I love you guys. I love connecting with you. Comment down in the comments below. Let's chat. You can follow me over on Instagram. I would love to get to know you better over there. I share a little bit more of my life on a regular basis. But I hope you guys are well. I hope you're doing good. And I will see you guys for the next one. Bye.